Greetings, fellow thugs. Welcome back to Zilta Force 2. We are continuing with our quick missions, independent scenarios, as I like to call them. The next mission at hand is Mission Payback. It takes place in the Balkans, 13 sun hours, the weather is clear, and as always, that's an ideal time for taking terrorists out. I can't speak today. Excuse me. Anyhow, the mission summary more or less says, a rebel armored column recently attacked a UN peacekeeping post. Proceed to Objective Tiger and Lase the armor for artillery. Armor column, huh? This mission, I don't know how it's gonna go. Artillery bombardment. But this mission, I honestly don't know how it's gonna go because, well, artillery bombardment missions can be, well, can either go this way or that way, because honestly, while they can be, you know, pretty easy at times, they can also be extremely difficult, like Mission Seal Coffin, if you guys remember that mission from Operation Global Enforcement. So yeah, I guess the only way to find out is to actually watch it now. From the looks of it, there's a guy with a 50 BMG, like a 50 cal, right, sitting there in his hands. So 50 cal in his hand, sitting right there. So I'm guessing this mission will have lots of snipers. So let's check out the briefing.
At 14:30 local time, an armored column attacked a UN peacekeeping force in defiance of a ceasefire agreement. These tanks then returned to their staging area designated Objective Tiger. Command wants the armor eliminated to prevent further attacks. Proceed to Objective Tiger and Lase the armor for artillery bombardment. Bravo will insert northeast of the objective and be responsible for lasing the targets. Alpha and Charlie teams will provide overwatch. A smaller encampment lies between the insertion point and Objective Tiger. Expect some patrols in the area.
So basically all of this is just fluff to keep us occupied until we actually get here. Now, given the structure of this level, I think it would be best if I take a sniper instead of the shotgun here. Now, they are giving the satchel charges as you know, backups, but I think the sniper rifle would be the better choice in this case. Should I go for the 50 BMG or this one? I think the M40 would be the better choice in this case. Satchel charges, again, two should be enough, but let's just take more just in case. And I'm going to, of course, switch over to, well, maybe let's take this. Maybe let us stick with this. It should help us get more, you know, stealth, should we choose to do so. Oh well.
This is Alpha 2. There's a platoon on the training course near the main camp. Let's keep it quiet.
Roger, Alpha 2. But there are going to be some folks up here.
Bravo, this is Charlie 1. You've got bad guys south of your position.
And east as well, from the looks of it. Targets have been eliminated.
Bravo's been compromised!
Well, really? I was under the impression that I had not been compromised yet. Oh well. Whatever floats your boat, I guess. But there are enemies all over this place, and we don't really need to take all of them out. We just need to stick to the critical path and follow it. Just take out the guys who will be threats to you, like the snipers, on the same side of the hills that you're on, and you'll be fine. We don't really need to take out anybody else in this level here, including enemies on that side. Or so I think. If this cut makes it to the end, we'll know for sure that that is the case. 400 meters. Done.
This is Charlie 1. I have eyes on the objective. I don't see the T-80s. Doesn't look like much going on down there.
And that's it. That is as much as we'll engage the enemy. Reloading for good measure.
All elements, this is King 6. You've got a large group of hostiles headed your way.
Damn it! It must be those troops on the training course.
I see. Now, while they say that, this is where where the other camp is. I think that's what they are referring to when they talk about the training course. And this is the camp that we do not engage. because it will get Alpha killed if you do.
Charlie 2 is hit!
Oh no. Charlie, you guys need to learn the art of stealth. You guys suck at it. Seriously. I mean, if you just take a moment to look down there, there are like a whole bunch of enemies. Nah, it's honestly best to just avoid them altogether. And Charlie 1 is at least, he's still alive, so I guess that's half a successful, you know, infiltration, if I could call it that. But the previous time around I got shot by somebody that I could not see at all, and I'm hoping that I will be able to see them this time around. Did it say shooters on the west? Alpha did. So I don't really know which shooters he was talking about, to be honest. I don't know what path Charlie is taking there. Seems to be a little too close to the enemies, but is that an enemy over there? Maybe we take him out, just to be safe. That works. I hear snipers.
Bravo, King 6. Charlie 2 is down.
Eyes on target to the southeast. Looks like one patrol in camp.
To the southeast.
All elements, this is King 6. You've got a large group of hostiles headed your way.
Again? Alpha 1 and 2, be extremely cautious. You're heading too close to the camp.
Alpha 1 is down!
So that's where you guys are. Sorry, my bad.
Bravo, King 6! Alpha team is down!
I can see that King 6, they died right in front of me. By their own stupidity. I mean, by the enemy's hand, but by their own stupidity nonetheless. And yeah. So this is where I'm going to attempt and lace the targets for destruction. Hopefully the enemy will not be able to see me, since I'm wearing a ghillie suit and all. Even though it will provide a stark contrast on top of the snow here. But still. Thus far, I have not been detected yet, and I guess that is where I will start my lasing with.
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Fire mission has been sent, we're just awaiting the arrival of the package, if you know what I mean. There it is. I was wondering why it's taking so long, but yeah, there it is. Sometimes it takes a while. Like, patience is the name of the game. With everything that you do in this game, that is. That's another target there that I do believe. Is that another target there? No, that's just like a bunch of boxes. That is a tank. That is just a truck. That is a sniper which cannot see us, so let us keep it that way. I'd not want to unnecessarily compromise my position.
Fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
So this is what I'm talking about when I say that this game has a few issues. It's difficult to look at targets and, you know, tell them apart from range. Apparently that destroyed all of that? No, it did not. It actually did not. And how many more are there? Armor. Okay, two armors. We have three armors actually we have already destroyed. There are two more on the other side apparently. And I think one of them is inside the bunker. So I'm just gonna crawl up to a better vantage point and hopefully I don't drop down. Crawling sideways because that's much faster. Don't know why these guys just had to go and get themselves killed like that. So the tank inside this space is probably why we were given the satchel charges. I think that is a tank. No, that was just trucks. Unless that counts as armor as well. I hope it does not. So win conditions are destroy all tanks at objective Tiger, reach the extraction point. And that's pretty much it, pretty simple and straightforward. We have taken out 3 tanks, I'm just searching for the last remaining tank at this point in time. Pretty sure it's gonna be in the bunker if anywhere. And to get a vantage point of the bunker, that is going to be the challenge to be honest. I'm just scanning that side for enemies that might try and kill us. Should we try and maneuver over onto that side? Just look at how fast we crawl with, you know, when we are moving to the side or to the back for that matter. But crawling to the front for whatever reason is exceptionally slow. It's a crawl. Always sort of wanted to make a joke like that, but yeah, here we are. Finally made it. I do think at this point I would have at least 2 more shots remaining. You see, these set of boxes always look like, you know, a tank to me. So, I mean, the fact that this game is pixelated sort of amplifies that issue, but at the same time, well, it's difficult to see things from afar, and people mostly put the blame on the fact that the game uses voxels instead of pixels, and I mean, I can certainly see why, because this isn't like rendered geometry, it's like baked in geometry. So these are all just pixels floating in space, and that I can understand why that might be an issue, because look how blocky everything is. Despite being all smooth and curvy, it's still pretty blocky nonetheless, because these are all just pixels, and yeah, that sort of makes telling the terrain and enemies apart from a distance pretty difficult, including things like those boxes over there. Pretty sure if we shoot those boxes or try to explode them, any tanks around them will also explode. But honestly, I'm just trying to get a vantage point onto the tank inside the dam. That is just another truck, we have already checked that. Now, the thing is, the game hasn't yet told me that all tanks have been destroyed, which is why I'm like crawling so much. There's a tank right in there, but I do hope that the artillery can get it. Like, artillery in this game is powerful enough to demolish buildings, and I'm pretty sure it should be able to demolish a hangar like this. Now, what I want to do is essentially confirm whether there are 2 tanks in there or just 1. And once that is confirmed, I'll be going ahead and extracting. Excuse me. Thus far, we have not been detected, which is good. I want to keep things that way. Essentially, why I got the ghillie suit in, instead of like an extra set of satchel charges. Because it makes it so much more harder for the enemy to detect. Even in real life, I mean, ghillie suits are overpowered. I mean, as long as you're prone or like stuck to a bush or a tree or something, yeah, forget about ever being detected. It's not gonna happen. The enemies can try as hard as they might, but yeah, they'll never detect you. Thus far, I can only see 1 tank. I'm just looking for an angle from where I can lace it well enough. Or checking for, you know, any barrels or some things that can be exploded to set the tank off. Because apparently I never shot anything there, but things inside the hangar have been destroyed. So that sort of gives me hope that I can pretty much destroy this tank without having to rely on, well, my satchel charges, essentially. And right now, we are meeting up with the objective marker, intended objective marker of the game. A long crawl, a long, slow crawl. And I have a feeling that the extraction is also going to be similar. So if the targets are kept close to each other, it's pretty easy to actually, you know, destroy them with an artillery strike. But if they're spaced apart a little bit, it doesn't always work, which is sort of strange because artillery strikes are not supposed to be that accurate. They just carpet an entire area with bombardment. I mean, the machines that they use for their attacks are not that precise, so at least the tanks in this game are not glitched, like in most of the games. In most of the games, tanks will know where you are, regardless of whether how well hidden you are or not. So, yeah. In this game, it's not the case. I'm just checking for another tank at this point. And if I do see another tank, I'll destroy it, otherwise I'll just leave. At any rate, the extraction is over there, over yonder, apparently. So I think we are on the right track anyway. Anyhow, I'll just crawl to the tip there, and then we'll see what to do. I'm really tempted to just stand up and walk there, but yeah, that's not gonna end well for us. It's gonna give away our positions, which we absolutely do not want to give away. Very bad scenario, very bad scenario. Alpha 1 and 2, lying there, lifeless. Now, I'm going to try and crawl sideways to it. I don't know how well it is going to work, but yeah, I'm going to try and crawl sideways towards it. I think I'm headed the right way. I just hope that I don't fall off this thing here, but yeah. I just want to get a good look inside that hangar there. All the shenanigans that you need to perform just to be safe in this game. Then again, I suppose we are Delta Force operatives, specialized in doing whatever it takes to get the mission done. I mean, I can't really speak for Charlie and Alpha teams over there, but yeah. Now, the official strategy guide actually says that the binoculars are a good way to determine where the enemies are, but in my experience, it doesn't really work like that. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, there's only one tank in there. That's good. No, there are two tanks in there. Okay. We are going to try another artillery strike there. And yeah, let's target the dead center. I think this is the last artillery strike that we have.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Well, if this fails, we're gonna have to manually detonate them anyway, so I guess I might as well try targeting the center there.
Proceed to the extraction point.
Roger. Roger, King 6. On my way to meet Black Widow. As of right now. Let me just crawl back onto the ice and then crawl out to the extraction point, because I do not want to alert the enemy to my presence, and crouching will do exactly that. Where's the extraction again? No, we're headed the opposite way right here. So, well, what we can do is crawl back up the hill and just, yeah, get back down there, I suppose. We'll do that. Alternatively, we can sort of try and risk it. I mean, we can see the Black Widow coming right here towards us. I just hope I don't get shot here. Was it worth it going around all this way just to get that one tank? Well, I suppose it was, to an extent. Charlie 1, your sacrifice was not in vain. The armor has been destroyed, even though you did nothing for it, but yes, the armor has been destroyed. Don't know why I'm so sarcastic about these. I don't know how to put them. Just trees. Just checking around to see if there are any enemies that need to be eliminated. We are going the right way, right? No, we are not. We need to be heading south. That is, I do believe, where the enemy encampment was supposed to be. So I suppose we can get down here. Take the long way around. Yeah, I'm not going down there because I don't feel like that is a safe path down. So I'm just gonna stick up here and just essentially stick up here until I find a good path down which isn't going to kill me. Where am I? Grimfangs is there. I need to be headed southwest actually at this point. Oh well. Over there. Super close to the base actually, which is what I'm trying to avoid, to be honest. I don't accidentally want to go to the base, because the base is west and I'm supposed to be headed southwest, so yeah, it's a little tricky, the extraction right now. That is where we are supposed to be headed. Now, you guys won't be seeing much action right now, but yeah, we just head southwest, direct southwest right now. I think we should be safe, we should be okay. We can just exit this glacier and just go there. We don't really need to circle around much. Like, let us touch grass first. Is grass south or is it southwest? Grass is also southwest. So here we go. Even though it does not look like it, the grass is also southwest. I thought that the grass would be south, but no, it is southwest indeed. Does not really seem to be the case, but okay, I'll take the map's word for it. Although I'm guessing I probably need a few lessons in reading the map first. Alright, we have successfully touched grass. Now to get to the extraction point, which is somewhere over there. Huh. Well, the extraction point is west now. Okay. Where am I going? The terrain does not agree with my decisions. It is very frustrating. I'm all over the place. I guess we just need to go this way then. The hike to the extraction. Maybe I played it a little too safe, I'm guessing. Because the extraction is not supposed to be this difficult, I feel like. Just trees, nothing else there. I don't think the camp is inside of us. That looks like a negotiable face. So does this. Although I'm pretty sure that face was more negotiable than this one. Is that an enemy over there? Huh. Strange. I thought I saw something. Nope. Nothing there. Well, I take my boots back, I guess. The binoculars actually do help. So with... in missions like these, where there are features in the terrain to give you cover, I prefer sticking to that and just... you know, unless you need to engage the enemy, there's no call to do so. So just get in, complete your objective, get out. No need to even let the enemy know where you were or the fact that you were there. Let them think that it was just a random artillery strike at their position. That their position has already been reconnaissance ahead of time, and this is just... a long-range artillery operation instead of an operative actually being there and lasing your targets for you. I mean, here's the thing, if the enemy already knew where the targets were, like if the Delta Force already knew where the targets were...
King 6 is a Black Widow. We have Bravo in sight.
Yeah, what about Charlie and Alpha though? Aren't you gonna ask about them? I guess you already know that they're dead. Anyhow, so yeah, if the Delta Force already knows where the targets are, what confuses me is, why don't they just fire artilleries at them? Because that's what I did in the end anyway, I just laced the targets. I mean, I'm guessing that they would have had the grid locations, you know, mapped out of the area, I'm guessing, because that's typically how it's supposed to work, but I suppose lasing it for artillery does something. Posse. Now, this is another one of those train hijacking missions, and well, we'll get to it. But anyhow, for today's mission Payback, I realized it was a little too long and a little too boring right towards the end. But yeah, especially the extraction, because we took a really long way around. But yeah, sometimes Delta Force be like that, and the way I played especially. Anyhow, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around to the end. Next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Posse, which takes place in North Africa. 8:30 in the morning, the skies are clear. So, until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow orphans.